You're fucked. Get him! Come on!
Show me what you got.
Dear, these tariffs.
It's the king who sets them, not me.
Would you decide to this is it?
You can understand it, eh?
Interest you in a pass? Cheapest around, right here.
What kind of pass are we talking about?
You don't know. Redanians hold all the fords across the Pontar. Can't get through without a pass. But you're in luck. So happens I've got a few to sell.
What? Could dress up like Radovid and buy a gilded carriage for that much?
What am I to do if you can't afford it?
No deal.
Whoa, hold up. Might have a little work for you. Reduce the price for a job well done, eh?
What kind of work?
Nearby. Just to the southeast. My sister's husband's got a business. He and some lads tidy up battlefields. Problem is, there's always swarms of shite bothering them. You know, them monsters drawn to corpses. Give them some protection, and I'll swing you one beautiful discount.
All right, see what I can do.
Well, Witcher, have you completed your task?
Why do you priests take an interest in the fallen so late?
The Church of the Eternal Fire's first duty is to the living. You've no notion of the work we did just after the battle. The wounded needed tending, refugees, pastoral care. We had sermons to deliver, donations to collect.
Relieved to hear it. What would the people have done without you? So, took care of the graves. Interesting, actually. One of the corpses proved to be quite, well, alive. And pretty talkative.
What do you mean?
Fistech dealer. One of them survived. Had an awfully interesting story to tell.
Intriguing. I would purchase this story from you. For all time. Exclusively.
You can hire me, but you sure as hell can't buy me.
Ah, an impasse. Then it will be cheapest to kill you. 3-on-1. Surely we'll manage, Witcher or not. Take him!
You burn, devil's brood! Ah!
Thank you.
guppies got their nest here. Rotfiend nest needs to be destroyed.
Come on. Let's go kill some monsters.
Enjoy living, freak, while you can.
Honor in the fatherland.
Long live Radovid.
I'm looking for Tamara, the Bloody Baron's daughter. Your brother said I'd find her here.
Wojtek sent you, sir.
How else would I know she was here?
Wait a moment. I'll fetch her straight away.
You're looking for me, and who might you be? My father sent you?
Yeah, to see if you're still alive, and well. I'm Geralt of Rivia.
I'm quite alive and extraordinarily well, Geralt of Rivia. Better than I've ever been in this rotten life of mine, and now that you've seen me, I bid you farewell.
Wait.
We've nothing more to talk about.
Got every right to be angry at your father, but he's worried about you.
I have a right. Thank you kindly. So good to have the approval of his hired thug. And my father worries only about what to get soused on next.
He's no saint, that's clear. But he's got the whole province on its feet looking for you. Finding you and your mother? Seems to me there's nothing more important to him now. I know evil men. He's not one of them.
Shame he never showed such concern before. Especially for my mother.
He made a mistake and knows that. I'm not defending him, just saying that maybe he's come to realize what he's done and what you mean to him.
Oh, wonderful. I'll bear that in mind. Did you really come all the way here just to tell me that?
Wojtek claims your mother had strange marks on her hands and that a monster dragged her into the woods. That true?
We were riding towards the river. Suddenly, Mum cried out, bent over, almost fell off her horse. I rode up to her and saw something strange. Her hands were on fire. And then that creature leapt from the woods. I don't know what it was, but it roared so fierce my nose bled. I saw it topple trees. I've never been so scared in my life. And that thing grabbed my mum and disappeared into the woods. I wanted to turn back, go after them, but the horses panicked. Now I don't even know if she's alive.
Before I agreed to look for you, your father told me his version of events. Tell me yours.
Mine? It's dull as life amidst the swamps. My earliest memories are of a drunken father lying under the stairs, caked in mud and clutching a bottle. Next dozen years, pretty much the same. Father would drink, disappear for days, then come home in a rage and send furniture flying. Thank the gods for war. I was glad every time they sent him off. And the quarrels. I remember him screaming at Mum, the thuds as he beat her, then her sobbing. I'd hide under my bed and long for silence. That's the long and short of it. Multiply by 19 and there you have my life. Finally, we'd had enough, Mum and me. He crossed the line and we fled.
I don't mean to pry, but I know your mother had a miscarriage.
His doing? He shoved her, she fell, that's how it started. We were alone, no one to help, blood everywhere. Worst night of my life.
Sorry. Must have been hard for you both.
Mum was in shock. She was raving that it was better this way, that she never wanted the charge. Must have had a fever. She was losing blood the whole time.
She didn't want the child?
Said she'd sooner cut open her gut than bear another child from his seed.
What will you do now?
Find my mum.
You realize that might not be that easy.
Don't worry, I'm not daft enough to believe I can do it alone. I've got some new friends now. Powerful friends. They'll help me.
What about your father?
Who? Oh, him. I don't care. I won't go back to him. That bit of my life? Forgotten it already.
Who are these friends, if it's not a secret?
No secret. Heard of the Church of the Eternal Fire? A priest helped me contact the Redanian witch hunters. Righteous, brave men. They'll help me.
Hence the candlesticks in your room. So you believe in the Eternal Fire?
Once the heat of the fire has set your heart aflame, it gives you strength and leads you down the path of truth for the rest of your life. I hope it'll bless you with its warmth one day.
Thanks. Thing is, fire's tricky. It's easy to get burned.
Well, well. A witcher. Never thought the Baron would stoop to hiring a monster slayer. Though I hear you're good at tracking things down.
Desperate fathers have been known to do a lot to find their daughters.
Unexpected from a witcher. I thought your mutations cleansed you of humanity. Stripped you of emotions.
You don't need mutations to strip men of their humanity. I've seen plenty of examples. Glad you know who I am. Haven't introduced yourself, though.
Graden, witch hunter in the service of His Royal Majesty Radovid of Redania. I'm certain you've heard of us.
Rings a bell.
If the Bloody Baron sent you to fetch his daughter, you'd best face it. You will fail in your task.
I appreciate your concern, but I don't need it. As for Tamora, she can make her own decisions.
Noble of you. A killer for hire abandoning his bounty for the good of another. The hunters and the Church of the Eternal Fire thank you.
Where are you gonna take her?
Tamora must rest. She's had a harrowing experience. When the warmth of the Eternal Fire has restored her strength, we shall see about finding her mother.
Before you go, your father asked me to give you this.
Clara? Father told you to give me Clara. Funny how he thought to buy me back with a memory. Tell him one gesture could never make up for a ruined childhood. So long, Witcher. In spite of all, I'm grateful you gave me a choice. Didn't force me to go back to the Tyrant.
Hope you know what you're getting yourself into. So long, and good luck.